Welcome to Dashui Talks, a show powered by Dashui Consulting, a China-based strategic market research company founded in 2010.
Hey, I'm Mathieu Chavon. I'm a department manager for TUV Rheinland, which is a third-party laboratory specialized in the testing, inspection, and certification for consumer products.
What are the common mistakes when checking the certificate of a buyer?
I would say the first one and the biggest one is to consider that you receive a certificate, then it's good. People have to be reminded that it's a piece of paper. It looks good, it has a logo, it has a stamp. It's easily fakeable. We live in a world with Photoshop or any other modifying software. It's really easy to do that. So when you receive a certificate, don't consider that your work is done. So this is the first mistake. The second mistake is to not know what document you need for the type of product. There are some products that doesn't need to have a certificate, but a declaration of conformity. Sorry for the a bit complicated terms, but a declaration of conformity is issued by the manufacturer, not by a third-party laboratory. So the manufacturer, they produce, and they can issue a document to say my products are compliant. But if you ask the factory for a certificate, and then this product doesn't need a certificate, then basically you make a mistake. But it's not as important as the opposite. You think you need a declaration of conformity, but actually you need a certificate and you messed up everything. So the second mistake is the absence of knowledge regarding the mandatory document you need for your product. And the third one is to not consider that we are in a really fast changing world. I can tell you that there was a third-party laboratory from Europe that was authorized before to issue the certificate, and then the European Union decided that this company cannot issue certificate anymore, or that they cannot accept the certificate. I can tell you that there are other cases like this, and there's official information online you can check, like to know what is the most updated information for your product to reassure the buyer.
When we talk specifically about products which are heavily sourced, for instance FFPQ number 95 and surgical masks, what are the best practice and mistakes to avoid on those products?
So on this product, I would say it depends if you are an experienced actors on the market, like you source product for many years, or you are a newcomer. For experienced actors, they know that the first thing you need to do is to choose your supplier based on the risk assessment level. And the level, you define it yourself. But in that case, right now, as we speak, this step is oftenly skipped, because I would say it's maybe people misunderstand it or they forget it exists. But when you choose a supplier, you have to understand that there are some risks. I'm just going to name a few examples. That are you buying to the real manufacturer? How many layers are between yourself and the manufacturer? The address you have for the manufacturer, is it where it's manufactured or where it's packaging? Since how long this factory are making this kind of product? We are talking about product that can save life or at least protect to have more dead in the different countries. So since how long this manufacturer are doing this? Are they doing the certificate, or are they doing some other additional quality control internally? So this is all the risk assessment on the manufacturer side, on the supplier side. Then, of course, as I already mentioned, you have to do some self-research on the product classification and on the standards. If you go online, LinkedIn, Baidu, Google, wherever, you just tap classification of medical device or PPE, personal protective equipment, you will find dozens of articles or PDF coming from official sources to help you to understand. It takes 1 or 2 hours to go to basic knowledge. Then, of course, then when you know the product and the classification, you have to request the related document to the factory. As I mentioned before, non-blurred. We see so many blurred, you know, when the address is completely blurred on purpose to protect something, I don't know what, but this is not a valid document. You cannot check anything. Then, of course, the step after is to double check the authenticity of the documents with the laboratory. And as I would say, this is a personal recommendation to have to add another layer of quality. It can be partial test. So as a buyer, you are paying for additional tests to make sure that the product that's going to ship to your buyer, it's performing according to its intended use. We talk about it, but for instance, the filtration system, you can perform a test only on the filtration system, but it's not a complete test, it's only a partial test. Or you can do an inspection per batch of production. Let's say you order 500,000 of masks and the certificate is 6 months old. You can add an inspection, so which means an inspector that goes on site, look at the product to say that this batch, this 500,000 products look closer to the golden sample that was sent for the certification. And then your buyer, the buyers usually they like these additional steps because it's exactly for their production. It's not for the whole production of the factory, it's exactly for what they are buying.
Can third-party laboratories provide a list of certified factories or products from factories?
So really, another really good question. So we receive this question, I would say one third of the requests we receive every day during this time, it's related to this list of certified factory or certified product. Here, it's a really tricky question because in our status, so for the third-party laboratory, we are declared officially like any companies, but we are also audited. And this audited gives us the authorization to issue the certificate. And because of all this, we have to remain impartial. If you go back to the example I gave you, which the manufacturer, the buyer, and we are in the middle, we are third party, so we don't belong to one or the other. And because of this special status, when we receive this request, it's impossible for us to give a list because it would mean that if we give one factory, the factory A, if my company said, oh, you should go for factory A, it would mean that all the other factory are less good than the factory A. And this is not the purpose. When we certify the factory or certify the product, it means that at this moment, this factory or this product comply with the regulation. But that doesn't mean they are better than the other one. It's something that people need to understand. And the second point is sourcing company, this is their job. They do the due diligence on the factory and the supplier. They do the risk assessment on the factory and suppliers. So they have the list. And I would say this is how they make money. So you should either do your own sourcing or rely on this kind of company.
Any questions? We will find an expert to answer them. Drop your questions in the comments or send us an email, dx@dashwayconsulting.com.